Hi guys, Jimmy here. Welcome back to my channel. I hope everybody's recovered from the New Year festivities, however you spent it. I know I had a few drinks over it and I'm just about recovered now. However, I might have a few more drinks later on after the football, depending on which way the results go. Anyway, today I'm going to do a vlog on three editions I picked up from a new range of films. But I'm actually going to do all four editions. I'm going to try and keep it under 7 to 8 minutes if I can. There's plenty of vlogs about them. I just wanted to put them on my channel as well. But I got a very good deal on them. And I'm, of course, talking about the Film Vault range. So I got this one off Amazon a while back. It's now gone out of stock on Amazon. And it's also gone out of stock on the Warner Brothers site. And I do believe on HMV. I'm not sure about Zoe because I haven't checked it. The other three are still available. But I've got a cracker deal on these three. So there was an offer sent through via email to me for 25% off selected lines in the Warner Brothers sale. However, I tried it on these editions and it worked. So rather than paying $49.99, was it, or $49.95, I got them for £37.50 a pop, virtually buy two, get one free. I was more than happy with that. So that's what I'm going to do today, guys. I'm going to pop all four of these into one vlog. I'm going to do it in reverse order because I've already done one on Blade Runner. So I'm going to start with 1917 and work my way down. If you can, guys, give me a comment, give me a like, give me a sub. That would be really good. Really help the channel if you could do that for me. That would be a solid one. But anyway, on to part two of this vlog, which is seeing what you get inside all four editions of the Film Vault range. Okay, guys, so here's a closer look at 1917, which is number four in the Film Vault range. And then this shows you all the goodies you get in the back. And then let's take off the slip. And here you have the main artwork, which is the two main characters crossing a no man's land to deliver a message to the front line to stop an attack that will lead to a massacre if they don't. So what made this film very special was is how they've done the camera work, which is one camera panning round on the main characters as they go down to the front line. Down to Gehenna or up to the throne, he travels fastest who travels alone, General Aaron Moore. So nice box there. And then with the crystal weight, I got number 727 of 3000. You've got the soldier's helmet upside down, which is like a fallen soldier. And then you've got 1917 there. Then we've got the actual movies themselves. So they come in this nice little digi books, come in a nice little slip, okay, which is the soldiers' clothes, if you see the material that they used on them. And then you've got the two main characters in the trenches there. Flip it round, and as they're advancing to deliver their message. And there's only one way this war ends, last man standing. You get your 4K and your Blu-ray there. And then you've got this like little soldier's tobacco patch. Now, when I first opened this up and I saw these pictures, this gave me a really weird feeling. So it's, you know, what most soldiers would have, their family back home, his children and his wife. And on the back, come back to me. So that was, yeah, a strange feeling when I first saw that, because you know that that was very, very true. And then you've got some character cards here. And then on the back, got some writing they told us would be home by Christmas. And then you've got, deliver this message, deliver this to Colonel Mackenzie, if you don't it will be a massacre. And then you've got, I hoped it might be a good day, hope it is a dangerous thing, hope is a dangerous thing rather. And then you've got, I hated going home when I knew I couldn't stay. So four nice character cards there with quotes from the back. And then these all came in this really nice patch that is Time is the Enemy, 1917, a Sam Mendes film, and it's the 18th Division. And then you've got four cards here, four art cards, Time is the Enemy. And then on the back, you've got details of the film. Shawn Mendes talking to the actors. And that's the camera, how they've done all the camera work from one angle, the sound guys. And there you go, when they're battling and the bombs are going off around them. And so that is part four of the Film Vault range. Now on to part three. Okay, guys, so here is number three in the range, which is Scarface. And you've got some new artwork on this one here. And again, we've got the slip. They're up there, it says number three. And that tells you what you get on the back. And then I really love Tony Montana sitting on his throne. The red blood coming down there. Absolutely stunning artwork on this one. And there you go, Al Pacino himself, Tony Montana. What a film this is. Open it up, Every Dog Has His Day. You've got the Miami Beach silhouette on the background there, which is fantastic. Love the reds that they've done in here. Red, purple going on there. And then I've got the Crystal White, and I've got number 1,212 of 3,000. You've got the chainsaw there. That scene still gets me to this day. The first time I seen that scene in the shower where they string the guy up and then they bring in the chainsaw gets me every single time. Really does. Unbelievable scene. And then your digibook comes in the door with the bullets in it. So that was a nice little touch, the front and back of the door. And then you have the main man himself, Tony Montana, smoking a cigar. Open it up. And there you go, sitting at his big chair. Say hello to my little friends. What a line. What a line from the film. Every day above ground is a good day. Mel Bernstein. And then you've got the artwork on the inside. And then that's the back. Really, really nice work on this one. Really nice work. And then we get the package that all the envelope that everything comes in. So we've got Tony Montana's initials here, Al Pacino, Scarface, The World Is Yours. And then on the inside here, you get some nice little extras here. So we'll start off with his green card. There you go. Antonio Montana. And then you've got some character cards in here. I always tell the truth, even when I lie. The jails in this country are like hotels, man. I don't F around with the help. Michelle Pfeiffer, good Lord. And I'm not a baby anymore. And then you get four postcards with it, or art cards with it. And then that was the original poster. Absolutely stunning. And again, it gives you details on the back about when it was released and everything like that. Brian De Palma, showing Al Pacino what he wants him to do. There you go. So lots of details on the back of these cards about locations, about when it was released and everything. And that is number three in the Film Vault edition, guys. Now on to number two. Okay, guys, so here's number two in the Film Vault range, and it is Martin Scorsese's Goodfellas, or as Beavis and Butthead would say, Martin Scorsese, which still cracks me up when I watch that episode. So here we go. We have the slipcase with this. And again, all the goodies you get on the back. Just slide this off, and there you go. You've got the wise guys, the good fellas, shooting somebody in the boot of their car. Love this artwork on this. There you've got Robert De Niro. I think that's when he's getting a phone call that Joe Pesci didn't make it. And here we go. As far back as I can remember, I always wanted to be a gangster, Harry Hill. So really nice silhouette of him running there. And when he does his first job for the mob, I think it is, setting fire to somewhere. Really nice artwork on this. And so of the Crystal Weight, I got number 1,311 of 3,000. There you go, nice little crystal white there. And then we've got the digibox that comes in with this case. And then here we go. This was in the club scene. They've all got their girlfriends and their wives working on something. Open it up and then you've got all the characters. One day, some of the kids from the neighbourhood carried my mother's groceries all the way home. You know why? It was out of respect. So that is a great scene. So you've got all the characters there. Flip it round. What a great picture that is. And then the extras came inside this nice little envelope. You've got the gun there on the front. Never rat on your friends and always keep your mouth shut. And they're the rules that you need. And then in this one, slightly different, you've got quite a few art cards with this one, all glossy finishes. And then they've all got writing on the back, what do you mean I'm funny? How funny? How am I funny? That was a crazy scene. There you go. I need this knife, Ma. I'm going to take this. Is that okay? If you're part of a crew, no one ever tells you that you're going to kill you. So really nice artwork on these cards here, scenes from the film. I didn't want to get blood on your floor. Oh, he's slipping away. Tidy these up. That's how glossy they are, they're sliding. I gotta admit the truth, it turned me on. That was the power that he was wielding. Yeah, you should be sorry. Don't F, do it again and give me the money. He's doing his extortions. That's the big boss. Place got hit by lightning, huh? F you, pay me. A 21-year-old kid with such connections, he was an exciting guy. That was when he was just starting out. And then, what is great with this is I didn't realise that there was a really nice double-sided poster. So flip this around, and that was the main poster. Oh, got to come into focus. Whenever that will happen. There we go. And then I'll flip it around. You got the poster there. And that was number two of the Film Vault series. And now on to Blade Runner, guys. Okay, guys, so here is number one in the Film Vault edition, which is Blade Runner. I've done a vlog on this before, so I'm not going to spend too much time on it, but I'm just going to whiz through it. So we've got new artwork for it. This was Ridley Scott's epic masterpiece. Harrison Ford, Blade Runner, the Final Cut Edition. And there we go. I've seen things you people wouldn't believe. Attack ships on fire off the shoulder of Orion. I watched sea beams glitter in the dark near the Tanusa Gate. All those memories will be lost in time, like tears in the rain. Time to die. Roy Batty. So really nice artwork on that one. Main man Harrison Ford on the back. It's gone out of focus again. Apologies about that. Don't know why it keeps doing that. And there we here we have my crystal, which is crystal weight 1,747 to 3,000. And then we have the digibook. Nice little shot of the city. And then here we go. I love this part, the eye. The replicant, there we go. Rutger Hauer. Open it up. Los Angeles, November 2019. And then inside the envelope here, you get quite a lot of goodies in this one. So, more human than humans, Dr. Eldon Tyrell. And then we've got some art cards here. So again, the art cards have information on the back about the film itself. And you've got some, you know, concept drawings on there as well. As I said, I've shown this on another vlog, so I'm just going to really try and whiz through with this one here. So the mixture of concept art and the actual images from the film is really nice on this. And then you also get with it a schematics, a technical drawing of his car. And there you go, guys. So that is my Film Vault editions 1 to 4. Hope you guys like it. Any questions, let me know. And I'll see you on my next vlog, which will be a bit of a edition versus edition. So Titans Cult versus the Film Vault is what I'm thinking I might do next. Anyway, guys, listen, thanks for watching. Stay safe. Sorry I went over the 8 minutes. It's nearer 10 or 11 minutes. Thanks for watching, guys. Take care. See you soon.